Hey everybody, Rich, Ponies at the Pike. Thanks for stopping by. Beautiful day out here in Long Beach. I'll show you some videos of some great cars. Thanks for watching.
Ponies at the Pike with a very special couple and a very special car. So hello, you want to say hi?
Hello. Stuart MacArthur from Portland, Oregon.
And Shirlee MacArthur from Portland, Oregon.
And they have an amazing
2000 Cobra R, build number 10.
And one of only 300, and their car only has how many miles on it?
27.
And they were kind enough to bring this beautiful, unique piece all the way down from Portland to Ponies of the Pike. So let's walk around, guys. Let's do it. So the MacArthur Cobra R.
Yes.
Yes.
So very low production, and Ford brought this out. This was supposed to be only sold to people with a race license, right? That was the kind of the idea, that these are going to be raced, and many were tracked. So cars in this condition, this museum quality condition, are hard to find, and they only came in the one color, which is performance red. So the 93 Cobra R was the vibrant red, the 95 was only in white, and this year thankfully they chose to go with red again.
Correct. They went to the performance red.
So let's talk about the motor. This is a 5.4 in these?
5.4. And the base of it is the Ford truck platform. Engine is the core, and they go from there to build it. And 385 naturally aspirated engine.
And yeah, it's all motor on this. There's no, but look at the size of the intake. So it has a special intake. These have like all forged internals. It's all the happy stuff. Really a unique thing when you think about it. That's why the sticker was astronomical on these, and then the dealer markup on top of that.
Correct.
Those gumball tires, those are the original pretty much factory G-Force TAs, the KDs, they specially made for this car, I would say.
Yes, everything was designed and built directly for this through several engineers from Ford.
And you look at the Brembos, right? Well, now they're on a million cars. Back in 2000, you didn't see Brembo brakes from the factory on a Mustang, so pretty cool. Unique body package, side dump exhaust, which is also kind of unique. Good luck finding those things now. Real basic interior, right? Radio delete on all these.
Correct.
Yep. AC delete and rear seat delete. Yeah. And if you look at the actual seats themselves, I'm sure most of these were torn out. Was this like a Corbo? Or Recaro? Obviously, yeah. But they are very basic seat. Not a lot of lumbar support. There's no electronics in them. I mean, again, it was meant for racing, hence the R. But yeah, you can see it does have the standard quote-unquote Cobra steering wheel, and then it has the SVT gauge package in it. But these were all business, and they're really unique and rare. Kind of the modern-day Boss 429, we were saying.
Correct.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So they got this unique pedestal rear spoiler. This is functional. This is because this car really went fast. I can't remember the top speed, but it was pretty high.
Yeah, I don't remember.
It was well over 150, I think, safe to say. This was the fastest production Mustang for a long time until the Terminator Cobra came out in 03. But it was the fastest naturally aspirated Mustang for a super long time. Yeah, not until the modern day cars came out. And that rear front splitter, we'll take a look at that. I mean, keeping that in that shape, but man, it's just such a cool car. Unique hood too on the Cobra R. Very limited production, fiberglass stuff on it. And you can see here, when you say wrapper car, basically it means, I mean, there's no plastic on the seats, but otherwise it hasn't really been totally dealer prepped. These stickers are still on here. The Ford quality control, the anti-theft on it, and then the window sticker. And jump at any time, by the way.
No, you're good.
So you can see the window sticker. What's amazing is this thing actually got 18 miles to the gallon on the highway. But you can see a hefty sticker price,
$54
in 2000.
And then the dealer markup of $25.
Yeah, and they bought it new. So the temptation for me would be too great to not want to drive this beautiful car.
Yeah, this car, everything is original. Only thing that's been changed, the battery, the tires are still, the original tires came off the showroom. So nothing has been changed.
How do you manage to keep, like, just the normal dust and things you would get even from storage? I mean, it's so clean under here. And obviously it hasn't just been sprayed with Armor All or something crazy that people do sometimes. It's just, everything looks just like it rolled off the factory
You know, just off the showroom floor, I should say.
It's kept covered, and when it comes out for a show, we would just dust it off with paintbrush, and it stays clean because it's covered, kept covered up all the time, and it's an enclosed trailer.
What do you do when you're starting it up? You have to worry about, you know, the oil settling or anything like that for sitting in the
image? We run it routine
or something?
Yeah, once a month we start it up, bring it up to temperature, let it warm up, and then shut it back down and keep the hood open so it doesn't, so it naturally will cool itself back off. Let it cool down.
So this is that unique Cobra R front spoiler splitter, they call it, and it has these unique fittings. And you can see that these are usually chipped up, broken up. Even cars that are being transported, it's hard to keep that thing from being kind of getting buggered up. It's just the way it is. But yeah, this is such a great car and such a treat to see one in this condition, not at an auction, and actually get to meet the owners. It's great. So,
well, thank you.
Kind of want to hear it. It sounds so tame. What a great exhaust note. Awesome, thank you. That's what a 27 mile naturally aspirated 5.4 forged internal sounds like.
It is signed by Carol Shelby. And Carol Shelby has signed it.
This was right when he was, like, you know, I don't think he was done with Dodge by this time, but I'm not sure he was quite back in the fold just yet.
Now, he was just happened to be at a car show, and because it was non modified, he went ahead and signed the owner's manual and the aeroplanum.
Well, that's kind of cool. You can see it right there.
Yeah. We did not want him to sign the dash because that's what it's typically they a lot of times do, so we had him do the owner's manual instead.
I mean, you could see this piece, this molded fiberglass, just how neat that is. Looks like it's on the steel frame, so it's fiberglass on steel, probably.
Correct.
Yeah. Thank you so much for sharing it.
Thank
Love
you.
It.